We also sat down with the chief scientist of artificial intelligence of Google Cloud, Fei-Fei Li, and asked her about the transformation of machine learning in cloud technology.
I think it's going to be tremendous. I think this is not only just cost saving because of the machine intelligence and data analytics, it's going to open up new businesses. For example, in financial services, suddenly we can have a better service in terms of banking, personalized banking, or in retail, we can have new ways of delivering products to customers. So it's AI and machine learning is huge. I deeply believe this is the driving force of a transformative time for our industries and enterprises.
Is this why you went into business? You left academia to come into Google? What attracted you to this,
right,
to Alphabet in particular?
So first of all, I didn't leave academia. I'm on leave from Stanford, and which is a sabbatical. And I think you're totally right. I've been a technologist for almost 20 years, and I've been working in the field of AI and machine learning, and I watched this field grow from a niche, lofty academic field into this major force of our society and the future of our business. And I want to participate and contribute in this transformation. And I thought hard about what can AI and machine learning contribute. And the key word for me is to democratize this technology. I don't want this technology to be in the hands of only a privileged few. So cloud is the best vehicle to democratize AI. It delivers the power of this technology to so many people and so many businesses.
As machine learning and AI really show what they can do, the question of ethics comes into machine learning as well. Is that something that you think businesses and academia is keeping a pace of?
I think this is an important topic that we should invite the whole society to participate. Every time there is a new technology transformation in our human civilization, that technology becomes a force of change in the way that we live, we work, we conduct our businesses, we do regulations, we create policies. This is inevitable. But the important thing is that all parts of the society participate in this discussion. And whether as an educator or as a technologist, I care deeply about this.
You talk of democratization. You talk of a farmer, a cucumber farmer in Japan, yeah, using Google Cloud. Is the prices going to continue to drop, do you think? Will the competition in the market as well help continue that particular trajectory?
So, Carolyn, I'm not a business person, so I'm not going to talk about price because I don't think I have many things sensible to say. But what I want to talk about is that the competition is not just going to be price. It's going to be the products we offer. It's going to be what we can give to the customers that they need. And I know and we know the customers are going to need powerful, easy to use AI and machine learning tools, and that's what I will be focusing on.
How do you think Google Cloud and the AI machine learning element of that is better than the rest?
So we need to look at Google as a company. Google as a company has the deepest bench in terms of AI talents and AI technology. Before I joined Google, I'm an academia, and I know that some of my best students go to Google, and I know that my Google colleagues, the engineers, the researchers, produce some of the most phenomenal work in machine learning and AI. If you look at what Google Brain is doing, the TensorFlow libraries, the work they've been doing in healthcare, they're winning challenges in AI competitions. We look at our colleagues in DeepMind, the work of AlphaGo, and many things. So I think Google is unmatched in its ability of AI technology and machine learning technology.
That clearly what continues to attract people such as yourself. I've got to ask you about the ribbon, of course, that you're wearing right now. It is International Women's Day. I look around us, and it's not a particularly filled of females.
You're
here.
Being charitable.
You talked about AI being a sea of dudes. Is that still the case?
It is. I think we should acknowledge that the diversity issue in AI and STEM is continue to be an issue. It's not just gender diversity, there is other diversity. Eventually, it's the diversity of thoughts.
What can businesses now that are led by men or that are looking to ensure that they have a diverse pool do as well? Is it about incentivizing more women to rise to the top?
I think it's gonna be a full spectrum approach. I don't think there is one magic thing. The companies should improve their culture. The companies should help women to build, support their leadership and career path. The companies should have better family benefits. And the companies should be supporting diversity activities. I think it's there should be an assortment of efforts.